Good day to our grade 10 students, to our science students. Sa video lesson na ito, ang itatackle naman natin is activity 7, Agassiz Outlook. Dalawang activity po ang ipapakita natin dito, jet, propelled balloon, and drinking glass. For our objective, determine the application of gas laws in daily occurrences. So materials, for activity A, rocket, jet, balloon. So string, sticky tape, medium-sized balloon, drinking straw. For activity B, the rising water. A drinking glass, bowl, water. So for first activity, thread a string through the straw and tie its ends tightly between two points at equal heights in a room. Example, handles or hooks. Or inflate the balloon and keep the neck closed between your fingers. So fix the balloon underneath the drinking straw with a sticky tape and pull the balloon along to one end of the string. So pull your fingers against the mouth of the balloon, then let it go. So, ganito po ang itsura ng activity. Simple lang siya. So, isasabit nyo lang dyan sa string. Free to move po ito. Para kapag binitawan natin is free to move din yung ating balloons. So, tingnan po natin itong video ng ito. For our guide questions, number one, explain why the balloon shoots along the thread at a speed using the concept of the gas laws. So the answer, the compressed gases have high kinetic energy that allows the balloon to move. There are molecules of gases that push the walls of the balloon and there are gases that push the air near the opening of the balloon. So the balloon moves toward the direction of the gases with a greater force. So itong activity pong ito, ginagamit din itong pang-demonstrate sa tinatawag na law of interaction sa Newton's law. So dito pwede rin po siyang gamitin dito sa gas law. So number two, what does this prove regarding the compressibility of gases? So the lower the compression, the higher is the amount of kinetic energy, the faster is the speed. Okay, for the activity B, the rising water, put the glass into the water upside down. So lift the glass up but without the rim going above the surface of the water. So observe what happens. So tingnan po natin dito sa video. Okay, napanood na po natin yung activity A and activity B. Okay, for guide questions and activity B, what happened to the level of the water inside the glass? So, the water did not enter the glass. So, anong nangyari dun sa level ng tubig? So, kumbaga po, yung level ng tubig, syempre, tumaas ng konti kasi nga walang pumasok doon sa glass. Ano po, walang pumasok na tubig. So, medyo tumaas ng konti yung level ng tubig. So, for question 2, what caused this to happen? So the spaces between the water molecules at the bottom of the basin are not enough to accommodate the molecules of gases inside the glass. So for number 3, if the rim of the glass was raised above the surface of the water, what might have happened? So if the glass is raised without leaving the water, or if the glass is totally removed from the water, the volume of the gas is also reduced, causing a decrease in the level of the water. So napansin nyo po dun sa activity, medyo sumama ng konti pataas yung ilang amount ng tubig. So, kumbaga parang na-magnetize nung glass. Ano po, kaya medyo bumaba yung level ng tubig. Pero kapag bumitaw na yung tubig, bumabalik naman siya sa same level. Let us try to make ourselves familiar with the kinetic molecular energy and try to relate the above mentioned concepts with the said theory. Or this is the kinetic molecular theory. States that gases are composed of molecules. The distance from one molecule to another molecule are far greater than the molecule's dimension. So these molecules can be considered as spherical bodies which possesses negligible mass and volume. So meron siyang mass and volume pero negligible po yung mga mass and volume ng molecules of gas. So yung din pong distances niya is mas malaki yung distances niya kumpara mismo sa dimension ng molecule itself. Okay, for letter B of the kinetic molecular theory, gas molecules are always in constant random motion and they frequently collide with one another. And with the walls of the container, A collision among molecules are perfectly elastic, that is, energy may transfer from one molecule to molecule as the result of collision, but the total energy of all the molecules in the system remains the same or constant, or the so-called the law of conservation of energy. So yung kabuuan po, hindi nababawasan yung energy, but yung energy from one molecule to another can be transferred to another molecule. For C, there is neither attractive nor repulsive force between or among gas molecules. So wala daw pong attractive at repulsive force between or among gas molecules. So for letter D, movement of gas molecules is affected by temperature. The average kinetic of the molecules is directly related to the temperature of gas. So mas mainit, mas mabilis po yung paggalaw ng molecules, so mas mataas ang kanyang kinetic energy. So the greater the temperature, the greater the average kinetic energy of the molecules. So mas mabilis din po ang kanyang speed. The kinetic molecular theory of the KMT explains the properties of gases and describe the behavior of gases. You can relate the early discussions that we had with this theory. So far, you have learned that gases have mass, volume, temperature, and exert pressure. The pressure exerted by gas molecules is due to collision among gas molecules and with the walls of the container. Yun pala po yung pressure, yung pagbabanggaan mismo ng mga molecule at pagbangga ng molecule dun sa wall ng container or ng lalagyan. The frequency of collision is affected by temperature because gas molecules have moved faster at high temperature. On the other hand, they move slowly at low temperature. The faster the movement of the molecules, the more frequent the collision, causing an increase in pressure. So mas mainit, mas mabilis yung galaw ng molecules, mas mabilis at mas maraming beses yung babangga dun sa wall. So therefore, mas mataas ang pressure. So let's check whether you understand the kinetic molecular theory. So try to answer the following direction. Identify and underline the possible weakness or flaws in the postulates. Write through if the statement is, if the postulate is accurate, and false if the postulate is flawed. For number one, a gas consists of a collection of small particles traveling in a straight line motion and obeying Newton's law. So the answer is false. Kasi nga po, ang tama dyan is random. Itong straight line motion dapat is in random motion. Number two, the molecules in a gas occupy negligible volume. Tingnan natin. Okay, naging false po siya because the whole statement, the molecules in a gas occupy negligible mass and volume. So number three, collisions between molecules are perfectly elastic. That is, no energy is gained nor lost during the collision. So the answer is true. For number four, there are negligible attractive or repulsive forces between molecules. The answer is